Dharmapala was the second ruler of the Pala Empire of Bengal region in the Indian subcontinent. Dharmapala, the son of Gopala, was the greatest king of Bengal has ever witnessed. He made Pala dynasty's rule as the most significant one, as far as Bengal's development is concerned. He greatly expanded the boundaries of the empire, and made Palas as dominant power in the northern and eastern India. Dharmapala directly ruled over the present-day Bengal and Bihar, and installed a nominee at Kunnauj. The Pala chronicles also claim that several other rulers of North India acknowledged his suzerainty. The most important event of his reign was the tripartite struggle for the supremacy over Madhyadesha of northern India. That involved the Palas in a long-drawn struggle with the Rastrakutas of Deccan and the Gurjarapratiharas of Malwa and Rajasthan. The northern antagonist of Dharmapala was Bhutsraja Pratihara of Rajputana and Malwa. While Dharmapala was pushing back the boundary of his kingdom to the extreme west, Bhutsraja Pratihara was expanding his kingdom in the east, with an aim to occupy the city of Kunnauj. The first phase of the tripartite struggle opened a clash between Dharmapala and Bhutsraja, the Pratihara king. Bhutsraja defeated Dharmapala in a battle fought near Prayag. In due course, Rastrakuta king Dhruva appeared in the scenario and crushed Bhutsraja to defeat. Dharmapala was the next target of Dhruva's northern campaign. After Bhutsraja defeat, Dharmapala regained the control of Kunnauj, but was defeated by Dhruva Dharavarsha of Rashtrakuta dynasty. Dhruva, however, could not consolidate his victory, as he had to return to the south to save his kingdom. A temporary space was created in the political scenario of North India when Dhruva returned to Deccan, and Bhutsraja was shattered by the Rashtrakutas. After Dhruva's death in 793 AD, the Rastrakuta were weakened by a war of succession. Taking advantage of this situation, Dharmapala recaptured Kunnauj and placed his vassal Chakrayudha on the throne. He became the most powerful ruler in North India and declared himself as Uttarapathasvaman, Lord of North. The kings of Bhoja, Matsya, Madra, Kuru, Yadu, Yavna, Avanti, Gandhara, and Kira also had offered their submission to Dharmapala's suzerainty. Though Dharmapala had conquered almost a major part of North India, yet he did not rule the whole empire individually. He had entrusted vassals to rule on his behalf. However, his fame and prosperity was temporary. The fresh and renewed attack of the Pratiharas appeared as a challenge to the undisturbed sovereignty of Dharmapala. With the rise of Nagabhatatu, son and successor of Bhutsraja, started the second phase of tripartite struggle. Nagabhatatu attacked the Kunnauj and defeated the subordinate chief of Dharmapala, Chakrayudha. This event raised fresh conflict between Pratihara king Nagabhatatu and Pala king Dharmapala. Subsequently, Nagabhata defeated Dharmapala in a battle near Munger. The Rastrakuta king Govinda III, son of Dhruva, appeared in the north and inflicted a severe defeat on Nagabhata and Dharmapala. Like his father, Govinda III then returned to his kingdom in the south. Once again, Dharmapala re-established his authority in North India. Dharmapala remained the dominated ruler in North India till the end of his life. He passed his time in peace. Dharmapala's reign had a special significance in Bengal, because after the death of Shashanka, disintegration of Bengal given rise to social-political anarchy. It was Dharmapala who had restored the province from being completely shattered and disintegrated. Under him, Bengal enjoyed imperial status, which was unparalleled. Dharmapala had made his mark in the ancient history of India not only as a mighty conqueror, but also a great patron of art, architecture, and literature. Simultaneously, he was a great patron of Buddhism, and worked for the encouragement of Buddhism as his state religion. He founded the Vikramshila Monastery, near Bhagalpur in Bihar, and like Nalanda University, it also attracted students from all parts of India and Tibet. He also founded the Somapuri Monastery, and is also credited with the grant of 200 villages to Nalanda University.